And we're back with more Pillars of Eternity. Exploring Northweald. Almost got everything completed. I think that's the way to Helia's temple, perhaps. The nest. A nest of a dragon. Here's a cave as well. They call it Northweald Cave. Yeah, very, very inventive. I always like to zoom in so we can see the details. There's a waterfall that we have to explore. There's a dead man who's we're able to talk to. Because we're a watcher and all that cool stuff. Hey, hello the young stag and deer and deer. Just gonna get these mushrooms. Yeah. Very trusting sort, aren't you? It doesn't even say we're seen by them, which is unusual. I mean, we're not hidden from them and not seen.
I shall be discreet.
There we go. That's how it's supposed to look. And now they really don't see us. We're standing right here. Right up. Yeah. We've gotten that good at sneaking. Alright, so let's go continue up this path here, or road. Whatever you want to call it. More like a dirt path. Let's see what lurks, if anything. Possibly we've killed all the inhabitants of this zone. And all we have left to terrorize are spring berries and the like. Ooh, blood. Oh! An Elder Stelgar. Well, before we start messing with this thing, let's kill that thing. Oh boy! We actually hit him. Wow, he's really damaged. He's more than half dead already. Well, what'd I do? Switch them? Stop that. I'm not sure how he's gonna get around. He'll probably choose some messed up path. Start off with minor missiles. Well, we killed that one. Alright, Adair. She's tied to that one, so she's gotta hit that. Oh boy. Let's just use up our other, oh, we didn't cast it? We'll probably do more damage just by doing that. Durance? A little healing. Still waiting for her to go, right? No, she went. Okay.
Yeah.
Right now.
Following.
Awesome. Oh, we kill that one too? Cool. They're really not hard. Oh my god, Alos doing that again. I hate that.
No problem.
Alright, enough. Shift. gonna talk to Estelgar. Over a ground hardened by dry blood and stomped leaves, the corpse of a giant Stelgar crawls with flies. Its flesh has been pierced and cut, as if stabbed by spears and slashed by swords. You touch the dead Stelgar's flank, a cloud of flies stirs into the air, and suddenly you feel the creature's remaining essence. The world around fades away. So now we can scry into animals? The pack rests. Rocks shelter the young, full bellies. You turn away and look beyond the trees. The moon breaks over their swaying canopy. A scent in the air stirs a tingling in your mouth. You slide into the shadows, the taste of hunt filling your nostrils. Light shines on the stones by the water that falls. Prey down below. Two-legged, hair like dry grass. It moves near the water that flows. We've seen that body. Thin legs, slow, noisy, unaware. It holds a sharp stick. Two-legged hunter. Weak hunter. Prey. Closer. Prey. Bright moon. Prey. Into the dark. Pain. Pain on your side. A sharp stick pokes out of your flank. You roar and shake it. It snaps, breaking on the stones. Wet stones, your blood. Leaves rustle. You look. Another two-legged, another hunter. Thick legs, silent steps, stripped face. Strong hunter, enemy. You leap, aiming at its neck. It moves, fast. Your claws find flesh, ripping it deep, ripping it down. Wet leaves, two-legged blood. It howls. It fights back. Long claws cut through the air. They slash at your flesh. More pain. Sharp pain. You strike. It strikes. Hot blood on your claws. Hot cuts on your chest. The world goes red. Your strength fails. You can't breathe. The two-legged hunter looks down. Wet ground. Our blood. Sharp stick above its head. Bright moon above its head. Strong hunter. The world goes dark. It's interesting how the Stelgar is taking note of the moon. I found the corpse of a giant Stelgar. It stalked atop the waterfall and spotted Arthwn down below. Then another elf, almost assuredly Fiorm, gravely wounded it with a spear. The Stelgar fought to save its life, but died in the resulting battle. Although I now have enough evidence about the Stelgar's fate, perhaps there's more that I can learn about the events that surround its death. Yes, that must be Fjorm's body down there. Alright.
Nice and quiet.
Nice and quiet-like. Alright, let's just see what's up here, briefly. An Elder Stelgar, another one. How long you been sitting here, guy?
Oh, got
him. All right.
Following your lead.
This should be quick anyway. Ominous voices. Alright.
Light, flame, and sound.
Oh god, everybody.
We'll keep to ourselves.
Can't go that way, huh? You know, it looks like we can. I wonder why they didn't just put rock there. can't take a ride down the waterfall, can we? They'll be interested, though, if there's a scripted event if we stand here. Oh, we have to go all the way around. What's this? Oh, that's the boot we found. Okay.
I shall be quiet as a calm sea, which is not very
quiet. Well,
I tried to pet a Stelgar once. Similar outcome.
He's awesome. Fiorm, yep. Beneath the raging waterfall, the corpse of an elven Glamfellen hunter lies shattered against the rocks. Broken bones protrude through its skin, but you also notice deep, parallel cuts in the rotting flesh. The slashes trace almost every part of its body, as if it had been ravaged by a dozen blades, or an Elder Stelgar. This man probably died before his fall from the cliffs above. You touch the dead elf's forehead, droplets of water glistening down its purple surface, and you feel a sudden jolt from the hunter's lingering essence. The world around you fades away. You're walking among the underbrush without making a sound. Moonlight catches sight of your arms, shining them pale, but you quickly dart again into the shadows of the giant trees of the Northweald. Your blood brother is not so daft as you expected. Look at him, frail, unaware. He doesn't deserve to share the glory of this hunt. It's been countless seasons since a Stelgar like this one, twice the size of its lesser kin, has roamed the forest near Twin Elms. Arthwn fell for the trick. You almost feel pity for him, but you've convinced yourself that he'd only get in the way once the killing begins. He'll be safer by the river. Expecting that we'll flank the Stelgar as he descends to have its fill of calm water, but this kill will be only yours. The Stelgar is larger than you imagined. It stands without fear atop the waterfall's ridge, its silhouette cutting a monstrous hole against the mantle of the night sky. A beast of legend, a true hunter. Your hand tightens around the shaft of your father's spear. The weight feels balanced just right as you prepare the throw. You put everything into it. The spear flies true and hits its mark. The Stelgar didn't even hear a sound. Its blood spills bright on the rocks, yet it stands unfazed. The beast pounces. Moonlight shines over its great fangs. Your hands draw your blades without a second thought as you lunge forward to meet the monster. It's fast. It's ripping your flesh apart. You stab at the darkness engulfing you, deep, again and again, but there is no slowing its embrace. I found enough information about Fiorm's death. His brother Radai will want to know about it. I can find him in the passage of the Sixth in the Hearthsong district of Twin Elms. I found Fiorm's corpse. His lingering essence revealed part of his last memories. In trying to kill the giant Stelgar by himself, Fiorm tricked Arthwn and fought the creature alone, dying in the attempt. Sentinel Ridge. Alright, let's head to this cave then. I guess after that... how about... Yeah. After that, we will head back to the Hearthsong district to let them know. Into the cave we go.
Shh.
Who knows? Maybe this eventually goes out and leads up to Helios Temple. Oh, we're still in fast mode. A forest lurker! Kill Eat! Oh, and one of those pogra things.
Don't even!
And two more forest lurkers. Okay. That wasn't very effective, I don't think. Fireballs.
Yeah.
Oh, she appeared amongst us here.
Indeed.
They're not gonna pass it though. Damn it.
Hey.
Following your lead.
Let's rock. That's pretty sparkly.
Margrin's fire casts light in dark places.
He's pretty upset about Margrin lately. Poor guy. Cave coral. Oh boy, there's gotta be something big over here, huh? Should... Big open space? Forest lurker? Earth Blight. Ooh. I've seen that before. Oh, there's a lot. And a Menpogra. They're so big, they might not have been able to get through all this. Just bide our time. Oh, ghost blades? No, that's not what I want. Okay.
Follow.
Oh god.
Following your lead.
He can't get through?
Nava, be on seek!
There we go. And now unleash the flames. Without injuring ourselves. kind of works out. We're shielding him. Oh, but Flame Blight came up here. Well, let's see if we can get off another one. They're fighting fire with fire here. Focus in here. Oh, he's all the way up there.
Stuck over here.
Oh boy. This Earth Blight is immune, or what is he hitting? Durance, do your thing, baby. Unable to hit. Oh wait, no. On him. Himself. Aloth's out of cool spells. Here, innervating terror. If that'll work on them, they're mindless creatures, aren't they? Oh my god.
How may I help?
By killing our foes. Where is she? Palagina? Does he have enough phrases? I don't think so. Oh. Three worms. Here we go. Fighting just to keep this guy alive here. Alright, since it's interrupting everything, just hit it. She keeps getting into. Oh, no, she did actually use that once. Here.
Eh?
Yes.
Did it. Awesome. There's somebody over there. Something over there.
Indeed.
Yeah, we have fought them before, right? Okay. Never mind. Just losing my mind over here.
I shall be discreet.
My eyes are peeled.
Sounds painful. Cave coral. Is there more to this area? No. a skeleton with an exceptional club, Glamfellen and stalking boots, plus 10 damage to flank targets. These boots are worn by Glamfellen hunters and warriors when stalking prey or foes, respectively. Potion of deleterious alacrity of motion, pearl, and 247 copper. Yeah, we want her to keep that. Boots of stealth. Yeah, we'll just put the boots in here. Alright, that's it, huh? Okay. I thought this was going to be a huge battle with another named Drake or something. Okay, let's head back. Got a couple quests to wrap up. And we got time left, so I guess we'll just do it. Alright. Heart Song. Okay, back to the Passage of the Six. We have some news, but not the news they probably want to hear. Okay, at least maybe he'll be happy that the guy from the other tribe is dead. You speak like an old woman from the Fisher Crane tribe. Oh, I guess these guys are up here, yeah. Redai!
Tread carefully, Estermore.
You've returned. He glances at the huntress in the group. We hope you find the truth about my brother's fate. I've concluded my task. It's time to speak with the Anamemphath. What did you see? Where's Fiorm? Redai takes a step forward. Tell me! Redai, the huntress thrusts her palm between you and her companion. The truth belongs to all of us, even Arthwn. You know this. Okay, I figured I'd just tell him. I guess my character knows something differently that I don't. Redai hesitates for a moment. He wipes the sweat off his face, leaving traces of red paint on his hands. I'm ready to share the truth with the Anamemphath, he looks up, and I'll make sure that so is Arthwn. I've decided to speak with the Anamemphath, the Passage of the Six and Twin Elms, to explain the events surrounding the disappearance of Fiorm during his blood hunt with Arthwn. I'm ready to face the truth. Don't keep the Anamemphath waiting. They all say it. Yep. Bunch of zombies, I knew it. Hail, tongue twister of a title person. Anamemphath Bethel. Our paths cross again, Gallus and Anams. Yeah, whatever. I've been investigating Fjorm's disappearance. Indeed, Arthwn and Radai have spoken of little else. I do not envy your position, Gallus and Anams, yet your testimony may resolve the tensions between the Keepers of the Stone and the twice-split arrows. She steeples her fingers. When you've gathered your evidence, I'll call a hearing. Can I have a hearing? All right, let's begin. She nods. I will summon Arthwn and Radai. Their fates and the names of their tribes depend on what you will reveal to us, Gallus and Anams. I don't remember her calling us that. Bethel stands at the head of the hall, lit from behind by dozens of candles. She casts a long shadow across the floor. We've gathered to weigh the claims of Arthwn and Radai in the matter of Fiorm's disappearance. To that end, we are honored by the presence of a Gallus and Anams whose insight will help us render a verdict. Murmurs of astonishment echo from the front of the hut. New theme? No, we've heard this, I think. We begin with Arthwn's claim. He asserts that Fiorm lured him into a confrontation with the Stelgar, and that he slew the beast on his own. Fiorm, he says, exiled himself, fearing that knowledge of his actions would heap shame on the Keepers of the Stone. She holds up a tooth as long as her arm. As evidence, he brings a fang from the great Stelgar. On the other hand, Radai states that his brother was tricked and murdered by Arthwn during the hunt. A hunter of Fiorm's renown would not have fallen in the blood hunt but by treachery. Her shadow flickers and dances in the candlelight as she looks at you. And now we turn to our Gallus and Anams. We ask only that you share your observations so that we may find closure for these two tribes. She lowers her head. What fate befell Fiorm? Fiorm is dead. What? Radai stares at you. His face contorted between surprise and anger. He turns to Arthwn. How? You puny weakling, how? The Anamemphath whips her neck toward the tribesmen. Do not forget your place. Radai's chest balloons, but he quickly lowers his chin in obedience. Arthwn's eyes dart from side to side. The Anamemphath continues. It saddens us to know this truth, but we must still reveal it deeper. If this is so, how did the giant Stelgar die? I saw no reason to lie about this. I'm just going to tell the truth about everything. Fiorm killed the giant beast. Of course he did. Radai shakes his fist and looks to everyone in the hall. Arthwn is just a feeble hunter from the Tri-Split Arrows and a liar. Fur bristles along Anamemphath's arms. Silence! Her slitted pupils narrow as she regards you. And now we come to it. Claim the truth for the six tribes, Gallus and Anams. Will you stop calling us that? I have trouble saying it. Fiorm tricked Arthwn and fought the giant Stelgar by himself. They killed each other in the fight. Arthwn tried to cover Fiorm's shame, but lied about besting the creature. Your words echo along the passage of the six to the solemn audience. Bethel nods. It is as you say. We thank you for sharing your truth with us. The Anamemphath turns to Arthwn and Radai. Brothers of the tribes, let these wounds mend. Go in peace and contemplate the shame brought into our hearth. I'll have a word with you, she says. I've spoken before the Anamemphath about what happened in the blood hunt between Fiorm and Arthwn. Following the outcome of my investigation, she asked me again to speak with her. She turns back to you. A shame upon both tribes is not what I would have wanted, but we must learn to turn our faces to these hearth truths if we are to survive the coming seasons. Your integrity is a boon to us. Please accept this with our thanks. We gained something. I've concluded my investigation, blah blah blah. Radai and Arthwn were both wrong. Fiorm's death and treachery shames his tribe, and Arthwn's lies have now sunk his own kin even lower. Average adventure added. Sagani. Two days, 5 hours, this stuff takes forever. Hold on a second. Completed. Okay, yeah, we do that. Need to do that next. The library got undone again. What the hell? I'm pretty sure that was completed. I mean, twice now. Provisions and trade happens in the market. Northwest Heart Song. Green trails to you, Estremor. The nest, yeah, the nest above the... That's the nest. Okay, that's where we want to go. To the dragon is there. Okay. Well, we don't need to do anything else then. Oh, what did we get? Sheath in Autumn, added to inventory. Ooh, nice. Unique sword, one-handed. 18 to 26 slash and pierce versus deflection. Plus 12 accuracy, plus 45% damage. Plus 1 enemy is engaged, and plus 25% freeze damage. A legend of the living land speaks of a marvelous and dangerous garden watched over by the four guardians, Northern Wind, Southern Gale, Western Sun, and Eastern Moon, to protect the garden from those who would disturb its wonders, and to protect hapless wanderers from the ravenous beasts and carnivorous plants within. The guardians diverted travelers with their respected domains. Frigid and buffeting winds, glaring daylight, and the darkness of night. Three would stand alone each season while one guardian rested. It is said that Northern Wind left this sword sheathed in the mountain snows each year during its autumn respite. Wow, huh? What does he have? Where's this? So, let's compare. We can add more enchantments to this thing. Superb. Exceptional. Now, superb is better than exceptional. Okay, obviously. That's a two-handed sword she's using. And that's two-handed. Huh? Well, I'll just hold on to it then. So, we've got one other thing to do. It's not to finish up a quest, but we should go rest there anyway. The Celestial Sapling. That's where the lady is that gave us that quest. So I know we're running over time, but we'll just quickly try to wrap that up. I'm surprised I remember the name of this place, Celestial Sapling. And we can get some rest there and perhaps purchase some camping supplies. Who gave us that quest? I think she was over here, wasn't she? It's not her. Down this way. She might not be here anymore. Okay. Not any of these people. Oh, I didn't need to talk to them. And this is where the monks were. And they're still there. Thank you for relaying the details of our fallen brother. Now, if you will please leave us be. Oh, sheesh, you're just looking for somebody. Okay, I guess we might as well rest. And she's gone, then.
Greetings.
Welcome back. Is there anything I can do for you? Yes, two, please. Can you imagine us carrying all this stuff? All these, yeah, sell them. Not even worth that much. Yeah, so it was all the hoods and helmets that were the straws that broke the camel's back, I guess. Okay, we're full on that.
How do you do?
One resolve plus one. Celestial sweet. Lord Brunegar, a cruel ruler from the north, has arrived at the stronghold. Send escort. Ravius. Okay, we are well rested and we can get the hell out of here. Down, please. Okay, thanks for watching. I guess we'll pick up at the nest next episode. Heading up to one of our final journeys to fight an actual dragon. Might fight it next episode, I don't know. We might be exploring first. I don't know how much there is to do before we reach him. Or her. Or it. Hey, thanks for watching. See you next time. And endure. In enduring, grow strong.